I'm Jason, the festival director for I Light Singapore Bicentennial Edition. I have with me this afternoon Kirk, Julie and Lucia from ACTLD. Today, we are going to talk a little bit about the multimedia show Bridges of Time. To start off, maybe I can invite Kirk to share with us a little bit more about ACTLD.
We're very excited to be part of the Bicentennial, and I think we created a story of 700 years of Singaporean history through the eyes of the universal traveler, which I think encompasses all the things that are really essential for that history. The title is Bridges of Time, which is perfectly in line, of course, with the festival's theme that we had. And we're very, very excited, actually, to be able to pull this off here.
When we first looked at the proposal that came in, I was very much drawn to the whole concept of a universal traveler going on a magical journey. Julie, to tell us a little bit more about the inspiration behind the whole story for the Bridges of Time.
Yeah, so we were really inspired by the festival's theme originally, which was the Bridges of Time, so the notion of time, time travel. And we did a lot of in-depth research about the history and culture of Singapore and connecting all the dots with this notion of time and all the discovery we made about your culture. It came really naturally to write the story of this universal traveler that represents all the travelers that arrived in Singapore over the last centuries and that will keep coming over the future. And this traveler is a bit the storyteller, so he will like guide the public through the show from past, present and future times.
What were the inspirations? How do you go about to translate the concept that you have of this magical story into the entire multimedia show?
We envision this story into a whole immersive experience, so it becomes a multimedia show that we based ourselves on water in this case. We have this canvas of very contemporary skyscrapers, very unique place, the river historical place where Raffles arrived, and we wanted to really keep this historical background against the contemporary skyline. And we have created a landscape that really keeps this ancient feeling with the organic look of the water and all the effects. We have light, lasers, video projection, a lot of different things that we combine together to really create a magical scenery that is floating just in front of the contemporary landscape, which really works very well. We're very happy about that. It really creates a link between the past, the future and the present.
Well, we're certainly excited and looking forward to seeing the whole show. But with something so complex and very sophisticated, it must have been a very tedious process, perhaps a laborious process, to go through the entire planning and preparation. Would Lucia, you be able to let us know what you all went through?
We worked through three main phases: concept design, design development and production. And we work very closely with local and international teams to be able to achieve a successful show that everyone will be able to see here.
We also spend a lot of time with the festival team and with the historians of Singapore to make sure that the vision we have of the show is accurate and right, and that all Singaporeans can feel proud and happy to rediscover the history through our eyes.
So I must say that it has been a joy for us as the organizing committee working with the ACTLD team. Tell us a little bit more about some of the challenges that ACTLD faced along the way. Kurt, something on your mind that you can share?
Having worked in about 30 plus countries all over the world, there are different methodologies that we have to apply. The one here in Singapore was one of extreme detail in preparation, which is sometimes, you know, hard for us to be able to imagine every detail before we actually come on site. But on the other hand, it also means that once you come on site, everything is actually dealt with and it actually goes very smoothly. Even, you know, monsoon season, lots of rain, lots of other elements, the Singapore River, which is a very delicate ecosystem that we have to really take care of.
And apart from what Kurt shared, perhaps Lucia, you can tell us a little bit about how sustainability is part of your planning and your execution, because I Light Singapore is also positioned as Asia's leading sustainability light art festival.
We have embraced this philosophy all over the process since the very beginning until now that we are here, and we're very, very, very careful to don't do anything that can affect the environment we're working in. Neither the river itself, but also all the heart of Singapore, because we are working really in the center of the city.
So as a part of our measures, we are using biodegradable materials. We are using all our lighting as LED sources that are the most efficient sources in the market at the moment. All the scenario is on floating platforms, so we are taking care, as Koert said before, of the bed side of the river. And we also use the water of the river for our fountains in the show.
We at ACTLD were looking forward to welcoming you here at iLight Singapore Bicentennial Edition 2019.
We really hope that you'll be moved by the history of Singapore illustrated in this fairy tale experience.
See you at this year's iLight Singapore.